accept that he was a progressive Muslim. Now, if that term is used by Orthodox Muslims, you know what progressive means. I was a student in Aligarh University, as I did remark in the film, when there was an announcement that there was going to be a lecture by Hamid Dalwai at Aligarh University. I did not even know who Hamid Dalwai was, so I did not bother to follow what happened. But 2 days later, I heard that this bloody kafir came and we drove him away. And we did not allow him to speak. And this was boasted very proudly by a large number of students of the Aligarh University. It had been about a year since they had savagely beaten up the Vice-Chancellor, Mr. Ali Yavar Jung, nearly killed him in the Union Building. But I was all of 17 years old, and somewhere the Orthodox upbringing was beginning to, you know, rang lane lagi thi, so to say. Luckily, in another couple of years, I dismissed all these things completely. But at that time, I felt, yeah, very good. How can this fellow who talks against Islam be allowed to speak in a Muslim university? And that was the last contact I had with Hamid Dalwai until Jyoti asked me, do you know of this person? And I said, no, I've only heard his name. So she gave me Indhan in translation to read and Muslim politics in India. And she told me a few things about him. And just as Ram Guha says in the film, that I was absolutely fascinated
by the fact that this man could have gone off. Can you hear me?
Yes.
So I was quite fascinated that a person brought up in an Orthodox Muslim household could have such ideas, not only have such ideas, but have the courage to express them and to try to win people over to his point of view. It's not an easy thing to do, because we all know what colors fundamentalism can take. And the questions that he raised were also questions that had always bothered me as a Muslim and as a person who was taught that you must practice all the orthodoxies that the representative of the religion tell you should be done. And all these thoughts affected me greatly, and I just completely was in awe and admiration of this person's courage. And I tried to imagine what would be the reaction if someone today tried to say these things to a
largely Muslim congregation. I think he'd get into far more trouble than Hamid Sahab got into. I don't think people took him seriously. They thought he's a crank who doesn't know what he's talking about. But the fact is that his study of Islam was very deep, probably deeper than any of the mullahs who claim to be representatives of all Muslims. And he knew what he was talking about. And you can see where it has led, because someone had to light the spark. And that's what Hamid Dalwai did. Maybe he died unfulfilled. Maybe he died unsatisfied. He felt he hadn't completed or gotten anywhere near to fulfilling what he set out to do. But I don't think he was that kind of a utopian thinker who thought he could, his ideas would change the world. He was a man who believed in doing what he could. And that's what he did. And so, apart from the pleasure of spending a few days with Jyoti and traveling around Konkan, that wonderful part of the country, these were the reasons why I'm in this film.
तुम्ही सर्वांनी आता फिल्म बघितलेली आहे आणि तुम्हाला लक्षात येईल की काय दर्जाचा